I read a lot of books. I've always loved reading and getting lost in another world. So much so that I would do anything to share that love with other people. I was a pretty good kid growing up. When I would get in trouble, it was mainly because I stayed up too late reading. My mom would catch me with my covers over my head and a flashlight trying to just get one more chapter in before bed. And she would take my books away. That was my punishment. Not, oh, you can't go hang out with your friends. It was, hey, put the book down and go outside. Which, number one, how dare you, mom? And number two, I don't want to go outside. I want to stay indoors where there are no people or bugs. Side note, who else is super excited for all the bugs to go back to hell where they came from? No, just me. Moving on. Throughout my preteen life, my mom never really censored what I read, which is a blessing and a curse. On one hand, it was great because I could read whatever I wanted and didn't have to get approval. On the other hand, I was introduced to more adult content at an early age. Sorry, Mom. But that wasn't the case for some of my friends. And me being the avid reader that I am, I hated when my friends had no idea what book I was talking about because they personally weren't allowed to read it. And thus, the book smuggling scheme was born. Now, here's a little disclaimer before I get into this more. Looking back on this now as an adult with a child of my own, I realized that this was absolutely ridiculous and I should not have done this. But angsty Samantha did not care. Her swooped bangs and coontails could not be tamed. This story is centered around one of my best friends since elementary school, Abby. Now, Abby was one of those friends whose parents didn't want her reading certain things. And I said, bump that, my friend is gonna read what I read. So when we were in the 6th or 7th grade, the Twilight series had just come out, and it exploded like wildfire. Abby and I sat down and devised a plan. A devious plan. Her mom didn't want her reading those books because of the whole vampire, werewolf, Satanist type of themes. But I had already read the first book, and I was like, no, it's totally not creepy at all that a 1,000-year-old dude is wanting to date a 16-year-old girl. Nah, it's totally fine. Can you hear the sarcasm? Can you? Anyway, we came up with the idea that each time I would finish one of the 4 books in the series, I would bring them with me to school, hand the book off to her in the morning, and she would return it to me on the bus before I was dropped off so she wouldn't get caught with the books at home. It was like a nerdy drug deal, and books were our heroin. You got the stuff? Oh yeah, you know I got it, girl. All 800 pages of it. We did this for years. From the 6th grade to freshman year, we did this. We would have probably continued throughout high school, but I ended up moving to Texas for the last few years. And we never got caught. It was a foolproof plan. Abby even read the whole Twilight series twice to not get caught. Her mom eventually caved and read the books herself, and when deeming them appropriate, she let Abby read the books. So she had to reread them and pretend that that was the first time she had ever read them. Going through all that, we could have taken it to the grave. Could have being the key word. You know, when you get older and you've kind of become friends with your parents, and you think you can come clean about all the dumb shit you did growing up? Yeah, we did that. A few months ago, Abby and her husband Austin came to visit my husband and I, and we went out to lunch with her family. We got on the topic of how we were growing up, and Abby just straight up outs us to her mom. I expected her to disown me forever as her adopted daughter, but she was totally cool about it, and we all had a nice laugh over it. Moral of the story? Don't go against your parents' wishes, or do it and then tell them later when you're 22 years old and married. Sorry it's been so long, guys. Things have been incredibly busy with the holidays this year and with finishing my freelance orders, but I hope you liked the video. I'm hoping to finish another one of these soon. Side note, that book I got taken away from me mentioned in the beginning of the video? Yeah, it was New Moon. Thanks, angsty Samantha.